So Karim, you're based in Vienna, and you lead the innovation practice at Arthur D. Little for telco. What does that mean?
Well, Arthur Little, as you may know, was born in 1886, so we're the first management consulting company.
I actually did know that. It's good to know. Right.
So one way of keeping up with innovation and being agile is to participate to this kind of event. TC3 is a great platform to, let's say, interact with my clients, the telcos, but at the same time also understanding where the innovation is heading and what startups are here, what kind of service they provide. So for us, it's a good learning because we can bridge what startups are presenting to what our client needs are. And on the other side, understand how mature telcos are in partnering and experiencing the open innovation model. So as a global practice head of this industry called broadly TMT,
right?
I cannot pretend to do corporate strategy for my clients if I don't change myself and evolve into more digital thinking. And I don't believe that having a separate digital unit would solve the problem, because it has to be inherently integrated in your core strategic thinking. So whenever you do a transformation for corporate, and particularly for telcos, you need to inherently think of the innovation dimension as well as all the digital dimension that are helping these companies to sustain their business model, to differentiate, and also to run a lean operation.
So tell me about an engagement or an example of how you engage with a carrier customer. Is it more about strategy and you need to change your mindset, or do you actually get involved in the implementation of digital transformation?
Well, typically the way we work with our client is starting where they are first and trying to understand what kind of challenge, what kind of problem they want to solve. So very often they have to rethink, they come to a point where incremental, let's say, improvement would not lead to a sustainable, let's say, successful business model. So very often we have to reset the button and think of new business models. So we have a range of, I would say, business model, generic business model. We have five of them, and we help them, the board, the shareholders, and the top management, to select perhaps a couple of them. And the mix of these business model will become a new strategy tailor-made for that particular operator. Mm-hmm. So once we have the big picture of the strategy, then business scoping. So check the feasibility, check the resources, the needs, the impact on the business plan. That would be the next stage. And then helping them to going through the implementation, right? So typically, if you think of a digital transformation, where most of the telcos are in, mm-hmm. we will start again rethinking on the way they want to make money in the long run, what they're there for, right? How they want to differentiate, what they want to be famous for, and again, what kind of business model in terms of revenues and cost structure they should have in the long run. Then you start to rethink the product portfolio, rethink the way you interact with your customer, and then you go through all the enabling layer I was talking before about, and rethink totally the engine, that or the factory. That would even mean that you have to think of partnering on a large scale, doing a network sharing deal with your competitor. Or if you think of a cloud platform, why building the cloud platform by yourself if perhaps other players in the industry where you're active, like banks, have also to support business critical infrastructure, and they have also to invest in cloud, why don't they partner with them and create a cloud, so to say, platform that is relevant on a national level for both companies that are running critical businesses. So this has two advantages. One is to exchange, let's say, knowledge on how to run future factory or on cloud, reduce your cost, and accelerate the deployment afterwards. So these are innovative ways of thinking how to run your future business model, right?
So you have TMT, telecom media technology.
IT companies
as well.
Electronics, so the classical vendors, I would say. They're still around.
So what's interesting to me, you have the mobile operators, you have the cable companies, you have the over-the-top guys, and then you have the networks and content guys. And in fact, they're all with Amazon, Verizon buying AOL, and
absolutely.
And then the ad serving, it's converging. So the network is important, but it's about the engagement and what you serve them.
Absolutely. So operators have realized, carriers, telcos, as well as the classical pay TV operator content labels have mm-hmm. realized that they have to cooperate. So we're experiencing a very strong synergy here and convergence. Because if you developed your own, let's say, content and distributed the classical way, perhaps the reseller model doesn't work on the long run. You have the Netflix coming in, so you have to rethink completely your business model there. And we do support, on a large scale, global partnerships between telcos and labels, content producer, mm-hmm. To come up with joint venture supporting, let's say, a much more efficient a level of aggregation, and also securing long-term distribution deals.
Got it. We're going to come back and talk about your paper in just a minute.